Presidential election results constantly changing, as you know, the race remaining uncertain, and it is building a lot of stress in an already anxious year for so many people. Maria Guerrero shows us how North Texans are coping.
At Clyde Warren Park.
Oh, it's a wonderful day, nice weather.
Americans are finding sun.
Oh, it's kind of calming me down now.
And a respite.
Bliss, away from anything and everything.
Time when the nation's political future is changing at a dizzying pace. Martial artist Bobby Garcia says it's about finding your center.
You can't control what's happening in Washington, even in certain states, whether riots start again or however that happens, but you can control where you are. You can control the fact that you're connected to the ground.
The American Psychological Association found 68% of U.S. adults say this presidential election has been a significant source of stress in their life, an increase from 2016.
Just more like unease of what our country is going to go through.
Don't feel their heart beating really, really fast. Some people feel nauseous.
Licensed professional counselor Lee Richardson says post-election anxiety is real.
And I can see with my clients, they're already formulating plans in their head. Well, if this candidate wins, then I need to be concerned about this and this. And turn that off. Put some boundaries in place.
What are some best ways to cope?
It's just stopping, reflecting on what are my values? What am I grateful for?
Redirect that nervous energy into something positive.
I mainly work through it. I'm a quilter. I make quilts for customers.
More than anything, I'm trying to stay off social media, but it's hard not to.
Live in my present, you know, my present.
Take a deep breath. The world hasn't ended. Keep moving, keep going, because no matter what happens, we're all going to have to go forward together.
So today I was reminded it's okay to put your phone up, to take time for yourself, and just breathe. In downtown Dallas, Maria Guerrero, NBC5. The phone part is the hardest part. The survey also found that for some groups, stress around the election is significantly higher. The percentage of black adults reporting the election is a source of stress jumped from 46% in 2016 to 71% this year.